Remember we talked about Buddy? And Buddy is the police dog. And what does he do?
Protects the policeman.
Yes. Well, we have a police dog that's going to come in so you guys can get to see him, okay? But you guys cannot pet him.
No, not
really. Okay?
Okay.
So the police officer is going to come in and he's going to talk to you guys and then I'm going to take you outside and there's a fence. You're going to line up along the fence. Nobody is to go past the fence. Can you guys remember that?
Yeah!
Nobody is going to go past what?
The fence!
And then you're going to get to see him play with the dog and then we'll all line up and take a picture with him, okay?
Some of you may have seen me out and about at your schools because we come to a lot of schools and we do a lot of stuff with the dogs. Like, what school do you go to, Bell?
Huh?
What school do you go to?
D.O.Z.
And have I come to your school before? Have you seen me? Has anybody seen me at your school before?
No!
No, obviously I'm not getting out enough. So, in a little bit, we're going to go outside and I'm going to introduce you, like Ms. Lipson said, unfortunately you can't pet my dog, but I'm going to introduce you to Canine Benny. So, Canine Benny is a dog. He is my partner. I spend more time with him than I do with my family. When I wake up in the morning, he's by my side. When I come to work, he's with me. And then I go back home, and then he's with me again. So, I spend pretty much 24 hours a day with my dog. I have the best job in all of the police department because I have my best friend gets to come with me every day to work. What we use our dogs for, we have four dogs. You're going to meet Benny today. So what we use the dogs for is primarily for tracking bad guys. So when bad guys do like really, really bad things, the dog can sniff them out. And then we also use the dogs to locate drugs and bombs and other really cool things. Before we go outside, I have some cool baseball cards that we just got in. So you're like one of the first groups that I actually get to pass these out to. So on the front, this is my dog. You get to see him before we go outside. And then on the back, well, for you guys, maybe your mommies and daddies can read it to you. But it's a little information about where my dog came from. Bless you. Do you guys like that?
Say thank
I'm
you.
Get one
thank you.
You're welcome. There's one. I got one for everybody. Listen, if you guys ever see me out and about driving, you know, wave to me. Talk to me. I know a lot of times, people, for whatever reason, are scared of the police. This is my job. This is what I do. I'm the same person outside of work as I am in work. So whenever you see me rolling around, you know, wave to me. Say hi. I'm talking to you. I don't bite. Can you say come down and pass it? Did everybody get one?
Yeah.
All right, cool. So, I didn't get one. Adults want one. They look really cool in the fridge. So Benny, I'll tell you a little bit about Benny before we go outside. Benny is 4 years old. How old are you? Five? Okay, so you're four, so you're the same age as my dog. You're four too? So Benny is 4 years old, and he's a German Shepherd Belgian Malinois mix. So he actually came from Europe. He came from a whole other country. And I'll get to your question in a second. And basically, the commands that I speak to him in are in English. So he doesn't know what no, what stop, what, you know, attack. He doesn't know what any of that means. He came from Europe, and he came from the Netherlands in Amsterdam. And the language that they speak over there is Dutch. So all of his commands are in Dutch. Which actually makes sense because if there's a really, really bad guy and he's running away and Benny's after him to catch him, if the bad guy turned around and said stop, that would kind of be like an issue, right? You know, so he wouldn't do his job. Not that he would really listen to a bad guy anyway. But so I've had him, he's 4 years old. I've had him for about 3 years now. Like I said, he's my partner. I'm just gonna go over a little bit of stuff that I have because all the kids always wanna know, what's that? Is that a taser? Is that a gun? Yes, this is a taser for those of you that know who it is, what it is. Listen, I'm not gonna take it out. These are weapons. These are all very dangerous. Which brings me to my next point. If you ever see a gun, whether it be on the streets, this is a gun. I'm sure a lot of you know what guns look like. Okay, guns are not toys, okay? Guns can kill people. Guns can really hurt you. So very important, if you don't remember anything that I tell you when I'm talking to you here or outside, I'll get to your question in a second. If you ever see a gun, whether it's at your friend's house, maybe your friend's dad has a gun, maybe your dad has a gun, whatever the circumstances is, don't touch it, okay? Don't show your friends, don't show your brothers, guns will kill people, okay? Guns hurt people. So we never want to touch a gun, and we'll always tell an adult if we ever find a gun, right?
Yes.
Okay, very good. I just want to make sure that I get that out of the way. Okay? Last question before we go outside. Does anybody know what the number that they call in case of an emergency? Who said that? How did you know that?
911.
And if you do something bad at school and you're not listening to your teacher and your mom spanks you on your backside, that is not an emergency. Okay? Okay? Because if you call 911 for that and I show up, I'm going to tell your mom to spank you again for calling 911. So 911 is for emergencies only, right? If your house was on fire, or if you saw somebody doing something they're not supposed to do, or if there was an emergency, something was wrong with your mom or your dad, or your brother or your sister. What's that? That's what we do. We deal with emergencies. So people call the police and we come. So again, guns, very dangerous, right? If we find a gun or we see a gun at our friend's house, we're never gonna touch it. Right, I'll tell you a little bit about more stuff that I got here. Everybody knows what these are, right? These are for bad guys. We handcuff them behind the mat. I bet you nobody will guess what this is. Nobody's probably seen this before.
It's a
pepper spray.
It's a
pepper spray. No. Any other guesses?
A taser.
No, that's a taser.
It's a laser.
What do you mean a
laser?
Like a
beamer? Yeah. It's a laser.
Oh. So basically, this is honestly one of my favorite pieces of equipment. So let's say somebody calls 911, and there's a guy. There's a guy breaking into cars, right? And I get there, and I make contact with this guy. And this guy knows that he's breaking into cars, that's illegal, and this guy doesn't want to go to jail. So when Officer Frazier gets there, he decides that instead of going to jail, he decides he wants to fight with me. Now, I'm no fighter. I don't like to fight. I'm a lover, not a fighter. So having this is one of my favorite pieces of equipment, because you know what this does? If you guys see this little button right here,
you snap it.
When I push this button, my back door comes open. And guess who's coming out?
No!
That's right, Benny's coming out. And guess who Benny isn't gonna bite? Me. He's gonna bite the bad guy. I have not used it yet. I've had it for 3 years. Fortunately, I haven't had to use it, but it makes me very comfortable, and it makes my wife very comfortable knowing that Benny is one fish of a bite away. Right? So very cool. If I'm fighting with the bad guy, I just push this button, and Benny's coming out.
Can you push
it? No, because then he's going to come running around looking for me.
Push it.
Maybe I'll show you outside. So do you want to look at this outside?
Yeah.
Okay, you guys want to see Benny?
Yeah!
You guys just have to listen to Miss Dixon and where she tells you to line up at. And then when we go outside, like I said, guys, I just need you to listen up one more second. You guys can't pet him. You can't touch him. You can see him. From a distance, I'll bring them over close to you guys, but you guys can't touch it. It's just for your safety. Yeah.
Did you know the dog was born in the month that I was born?
Oh yeah? When's your birthday?
October 12th.
Okay, he's one day before you. But I'm sure you're older than him. What are you? How old are you?
10.
10? Okay, he's 14.
Oh, I am too.
I want to be 10 too.
You're very cute.
Me too.
You have a question?
How did you get it?
Okay, so you want to bring him outside?
Yes, I will.
I'll go get Benny ready and then I'll let you line him up.
Okay, wait.
Why'd you mix up?
Why did I mix up?
How'd you get water?
Because I found it on the side of the building.
Okay, you gotta use your hand.
Because this is like overwhelming for him. It's not every day that we come out and there's a bunch of people lined up. So he's kind of looking like he doesn't really know what to do.
I said hold her hand.
We'll wait for everybody to come out. He knows that I have his toy. So all he wants right now is his toy. The toy is under my left arm, right here. You see this tube here?
Okay, you guys sit down.
It's like a rubber tube.
Sit down. The rest of kids are coming, okay, Officer Frazier?
What's that?
There's some more kids that are coming.
Okay, no problem. Sit. So you can see, most of the time, Benny's attention is really focused on me. Benny's always alert, okay? He's kind of looking at me, waiting for if I give him a command. These dogs are very loyal. You have to understand that, like I told you guys inside, I spend more time with this animal than I do with my own family. He's a highly trained police dog, okay, which is why I have you guys on one side of the fence. You have to keep in mind, while I treat him like a pet, when we go home, you know, he lays on his back and I can pet his belly. When I put this vest on him, he knows he's coming to work. See, he's just a big dog. But she wants his toy. So you'll see, I'll just show you, like, when I'm walking around, you'll always see him peeling. He's always on my left side. He never goes to my right side. And honestly, I have my gun on my right side, so he stays to the left. So that the commands that I'm giving him are like what I told you inside, like Dutch. I'm telling him fall again, and that means heel. So if I'm telling him fall again, heel, fall again, he'll always come back to the heel command. I tell him up, up. He lays down. See? And he sits. And then I give him his toy. And just like you guys, he loves to play.
He loves to play with that toy.
I can spin him around by his teeth. Nothing means more to this dog than that.
Ew! Use that one to
nothing. Oh yeah, it's getting a little slobbery. Do you want to touch it?
No!
It's a little slobbery, but I don't mind. I'm used to it.
It's an airport dog, right?
No. We're city of Delray Beach. So he just wants to play. He can lay here and chew on this toy all day. This means the most to him in the world. That's what he does. He likes to chew on it. Life. Beat it. Leave it.
Good boy.
Leave it. Leave it. Life. Now if I can just get you guys to stay quiet. Life. Very important that when I tell him to do something, I'm not asking him, I'm telling him. Life. And he has to listen. Okay, this is part of our training. This is, you know, 6 months of training that we go through, that these dogs that we pick, Life, are the alpha males. Dogs are pack animals, so they like to fall into a group hierarchy. Well, I have to be his alpha male. I have to be in charge of him. When I tell him to do something, I'm not asking him, Life. I'm telling him. And you see, he's pretty obedient. He listens for the most part. Every once in a while, he can be a knucklehead and do his own thing like any other dog. But these dogs are very obedient. The training that goes into it, that ugly boy. The training that goes into it, I mean, you guys are just seeing a little bit, a very small piece of the pie off. It's amazing. Like I said, it's about 6 months with him. And that's basically to take a dog that knows how to sit and to making him into a police dog. So it's a lot of work. It's a lot of work for him. It was a lot of work for me. This is my first dog. This is the first time I've gone through this. Hopefully Benny will be healthy and I stay healthy and I'll get to work him for usually about 7 to 10 years. And I've had him for about 3 already. Once they retire, they come home with us. They live out the remainder of their lives with us, which is awesome. So once he retires, as long as he stays healthy and he doesn't get hurt, he'll retire, live out the rest of his life with me, and he'll just be my dog until the day he passes on. And then hopefully, the city will give me another dog. But that's so far down the road, we'll see what happens. So this is Benny. Did you guys like to see Benny?
Yeah.
Which means let go. Look, you can see he's still holding between his paws and hers because he doesn't want to let go. And you can just see his focus. Leave it. Some of you guys. Let me put him up for a second. You guys say bye to Benny?
Yeah.
Say bye to Benny.
Bye.
Bye, Benny.
Bye. Bye, Benny.
Bye, Benny.
Bye, Benny.
Bye, Benny.
Bye, Benny.
Bye,
Benny.
I can't get him too tired because we gotta go to work tonight. Does anybody have any questions? Close to four? I used to be close to four. Right now he's listening to the radio, drinking water, you're getting nice cold AC blown on him. It's funny, a lot of people, I'll run into like Pollo or Chipotle to grab lunch when I'm working. And a lot of people come up to me, oh, you're wasting our tax dollars, you know, why is your car running? I'm like, because there's a dog in there. Like, do you not know how to read? You see the big red letters? So that always cracks me up. But yes, in case you were wondering, the car is always on. Part of this bailout system that I was telling you guys about with the button that opens the back door, the front of it, if you could see it, it actually tells you the temperature in the front of the car, which is currently 77 degrees, and in the back, which is 79 degrees. So in the event, if the car stalled, which it happens, you know, it's hot, it's Florida, and cars stall and things break. If that were to happen, once the internal temperature in the car reaches 90 degrees, the back windows roll down, the alarm goes off, the sirens go off, and I actually, I get a call on my cell phone. We have this thing set up where it calls my cell phone. So I know you've probably maybe heard or seen online. It's unfortunate, but it happens from time to time. A canine handler will leave the dog in the car. It's happened before. In Florida, you know, it's a matter of time before they have, heat stroke. So that prevents that issue. Any other questions down here?
I have a question.
Your sister's four.
How
do you say stop? The question was, how do you tell him stop? There really isn't a stop. It's more of a stay, which in Dutch it's live. L-I-V, live. So a couple times you might have heard me tell him when he's laying down, live. That just means like stay. So that's
what language? East language?
Dutch.
Do all the dogs speak Dutch, or is just his particular dog?
Yeah. In my line of duty with the dog, I can't put a bad guy in that seat, in my back seat. So I haven't personally arrested anybody in a couple of years, but there has been times in the past where, yeah, I have arrested kids, but it's because they were doing something very bad, and they shouldn't have done. It's unfortunate, but it's not. As long as you listen to your mom, your dad, your teachers, and you guys do the right thing, you'll never have a problem, right?
Yes,
right. Yes.
I have the moment. I guess I watched when kids went to jail.
Oh yeah, you saw it on TV?
Yeah, I've seen
that. Those are really, really bad kids. None of you guys would ever grow up and do that knucklehead stuff though.
I'm gonna put I have like little kids like crack
I've seen the show, it's Scared Straight or something like that. I've been in the force for since 2010,
and
so
you know
a little
what?
Over 6 years.
I was
Oh, you wanted to see the police station for your birthday?
Yeah, because there was this police guy who was very nice to us, and I said, can we go to the police station so I can go say hi?
Very cool.
And my dad said yes.
And your daddy took you there?
Yeah.
That was very nice.
And when we were leaving, we saw a kid that had handcuffs.
Oh, yeah? He must have done something very bad. Yes, sir.
What is that?
This right here, that's a good question. He just asked me, what is this?
That's a
camera. That's right, who said that? Very good,
clap it up.
We just got these. This is a body camera. We actually just rolled out this pilot program where 20 cameras are out right now in the force. So I'm one of 20. And basically what it is, at the top, at your top left, my top right, is a lens right here. Records everything. So whenever I go to a call, I tap the center button and the camera comes on. It's a different world that we live in now. You know, people hate the police, people fight the police, people resist the police. So it's nice to have more than just my word. It's nice to have it on camera. You know, you have clear video, you have clear audio. So it's not just, what's your name?
Mariah.
So it's not just Mariah attacked me.
Mikey.
It's on 1080p high def and audio. So it paints a picture. You know what I mean? Because just saying that you punched me in the face and I fell and I grabbed you, it doesn't really do justice. Seeing it on video and audio makes it clear. You know, it keeps us honest. You know, are there bad police out there in the world? I, of course there are. But my response to that is in every aspect of life, in schools, and you know, teachers, nurses, doctors. You know, unfortunately, there's bad people in every field. At my experience at the police department in 6 years, I've never met one cop that I can honestly say was a bad person. We all make mistakes, but this just keeps everybody accountable. It keeps you honest and accountable. It keeps me honest and accountable. And that's the whole purpose of it. And I agree with it. I like them. I love them.
Can we phone the line so that you can take?
Yeah. Let's do
you
that.
You want
now.
Me to do it here? Or
you know what?
I have something.
We could do it out here.
Okay.
We can do it out here.
Okay.
So we're gonna take a quick picture.
Team leaders, I need you to bring the kids that you're responsible for and line them up here.
All right,
Yeah, unfortunately, like I said inside, guys, you can't touch them. But at least we'll have a cool picture.
Come this way, guys.